January 19, 2038. 3:14 a.m. and 7 seconds UTC. Every computer in the world is going to break and malfunction. Any system that relies on time will fail just like that, unless something is done to address it. So, why does this time traveling phenomenon happen? In this video, we will explore the cause behind the year 2038 problem. This issue affects every 32-bit system that measures Unix time. Let us take a deeper look at this. Unix time counts the number of seconds since midnight UTC, 1st January 1970. This is defined as the Unix epoch. Why this specific date and time? Unix engineers simply arbitrarily chose this because the new year seems like a convenient time to work with. Anyway, this time is stored in the 32-bit signed integer. Back in the day, when memory was expensive, it made sense to be more conservative with data type choices. The problem is that, as with all data types, there is a maximum limit to the value it can store. For a 32-bit signed integer, it is capable of representing any number between negative 2 to the power of 31 to 2 to the power of 31 minus 1. The reason it is 2 to the power of 31 bits and not 32 is because the first bit is reserved to denote whether the number is positive or negative, which is the meaning of signed. However, this bit is not simply a flag for the negative sign. For computers, we typically use the 2's complement method to represent such signed integers. We know that in binary, the least significant bit at the right here is equal to 2 to the power of 0, which is 1. Then we have 2 to the power of 1, 2 to the power of 2, and so on. This goes up to 2 to the power of 30, and it all works the same. But here comes the special part. The 32nd bit here actually represents negative 2 to the power of 31. So for example, we have that bit and the last 3 bits set as well. To find the value, just sum the values of the bits that are set. This is contrary to an unsigned 32-bit integer where the 32nd bit represents 2 to the power of 31. Hence, for that, you get a range between 0 and 2 to the power of 32 minus 1, which is 4,294,967,295. On the contrary, the maximum positive integer that the signed 32-bit integer can represent is only 2,147,483,647. That is quite a significant difference. That number is the most number of seconds after the Unix epoch which you can store, which translates to 3:14 a.m. and 07 seconds UTC on 19 January 2038. What happens to any time after that, you might ask? Well, the epochalypse. This is where an integer overflow will occur. An integer overflow happens when you try to store a value larger than what it can hold. So, imagine trying to add 1 to the Unix time variable once it is at its largest value. In binary, we see the overflow in action. 31 bits are currently filled with 1s, which is the maximum positive value. Adding 1 to the current value sets this bit to 1, and everything else to 0, which makes the Unix time negative 2 to the power of 31. Which is negative 2,147,483,648 seconds before midnight UTC, New Year's Day of 1970. This is why we get the time being displayed as 8:45 p.m. and 52 seconds UTC on 13 December 1901. This might pose a problem when you have functions that are dependent on time. If a software program has a function that checks for timeouts, for example, unintended behaviors might occur. Or in the worst case, things start to crash. Think about the example where there is a function that looks at the current Unix time and does a comparison to see if it is earlier than the target time. Assume that this function does a check every 5 seconds. At this point in time, all is well and the condition passes as expected. After 5 seconds, we should have theoretically passed the target time and the condition should fail. This is not the case though, as the condition continues to be satisfied since the Unix time has overflowed. Our check is now officially broken. So, does that mean that all computers are doomed? Well, not exactly. We actually had a similar issue in the year 2000, known as the year 2000 problem. Yes, indeed, they are all very original names. Engineers had to grapple with the fact that the calendar year represented on computers for the year 2000 is 00. This was a challenge as it was indistinguishable from the year 1900s. It resulted in a range of responses from various countries, with countries like Australia investing in millions to prepare for the problem, while Russia, on the other hand, did absolutely nothing. In the end, there were no major technological issues at all, and it seemed like everyone panicked for no reason. But we will never really know what might happen in 2038 again. Better safe than sorry, maybe? While there's no common consensus on how to respond then, and certainly none for 2038, people have been trying their best to avoid this problem by using signed 64-bit integers nowadays. So by postponing the problem for future engineers, we have solved it. Genius, isn't it? Who said procrastination cannot be useful? Anyway, thank you for watching, and let me know what you want to see next.